Hi everybody, this is a how-to video that I'm putting together as different teaching materials, but if you use Zoom, this will also be useful for you. I am CR Grimmer, this is my channel, The Poetry Vlog, and this sequence is part of a larger playlist. You can link in the eye icon on your YouTube screen above, and there you'll find the videos that pair with this. So in this video, we'll focus on Zoom and Canvas. Again, if you're looking for the video on Zoom in the cloud in general, you'll find it in the playlist this is on my channel. You'll find it in the card popping up that has a little eye for information in the top of the screen. And of course, you can always just search CR Grimmer Zoom Cloud Tutorial and it will come right up. As always, let me know in the comments about other videos you think should be on this playlist so we can generate this how-to sort of master list. Remember that these are useful to students as well as teachers, and let me know in the comments what's helpful or not helpful as we generate these technologies. Here I am in my Canvas course shell. I'm going to scroll all the way down to Zoom in the left-hand side. It's towards the bottom for me. And then I'll see all of my Zoom options within the course. Previous meetings, personal meeting rooms, and cloud recordings just for that class. Now, what if I want to see something I've recorded elsewhere? I click on that All Zoom Meetings and Clouds, and I can go to Previous Meetings and Cloud Recordings. Under Cloud Recordings, I can select the meeting I want to share. Here, I'll select the 1 GB, that's 4 different files for a team meeting, and you can see what happens. You can choose to try to download it, which will sometimes work and sometimes not, or you can choose to share it with the rest of the class via a link. So if you click share, you have to copy paste this and do a course announcement or anywhere you want students to go in order to access the recording. Now there's also this publish button. If you click publish, all of the students in that class will be able to access this file set right here. And you can see the different audio and video files separated out. I recommend going in and renaming them when possible. So for instance, if we go here and we want to see the isolated different recording files, and I'll be able to view the video with the auto transcript right there over on the right hand side. So I'm going to scroll over on my screen a bit for you to see this a little bit better. What we have here is the automatic transcript for everything I said in that Zoom meeting. This is different from how the different Zoom files save into the cloud if you're not using Canvas. But if that's all you needed to know, now you know how to access them within your actual Canvas course shell. Which one you would prefer will depend on a variety of pros and cons. I am going to edit in the exact same pros and cons list in each video, so if you see that duplicated, know you're watching the right video. I just want to make sure that you know which one you prefer no matter which video you watch. So pros, if you're an instructor or student and Zoom is integrated into the Canvas portal, you can just toggle on publish, which will be shown in the how-to video, and anyone in that class can now view the video, the transcript, and the audio recording by streaming it and having to sign in to the Zoom Canvas portal. The con is you have very little control over the types of files that are recorded and that you share, the privacy settings for downloading, and easily naming and manipulating the files. So if you're saving your Zoom video files to the cloud and you're not going to use the Canvas integration, it might be because you either don't have it or you prefer to have a little bit more control over what you're sharing. In that case, the pros would be you'll have multiple file types, gallery view, speaker view, audio, transcript, chat, all of them will be right there. You'll have the capacity to name them. There's multiple ways to share the individual files, so just the audio, just the chat, just the video, whatever you prefer. You can set up password protection on it, and you can set it up so that anybody who has the share link is unable to download the file. Again, what you prefer really depends on what you're comfortable with. I recommend if you're feeling anxious about using Zoom in the classroom and you have Canvas and you want the least work possible, just click publish and save them to the cloud and use Canvas integration. If you don't have Canvas or if you want to have that extra layer of control, then I recommend learning how to access them in the cloud and share from there.